Try to remember the kind of September when life was slow and oh, so mellow. Try to remember the kind of September when grass was green and grain was yellow. Try to remember the kind of September when you were a tender and callow fellow. Try to remember, and if you remember, then follow.
Follow, 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 follow.
Try to remember when life was so tender that no one wept except the willow. Try to remember when life was so tender that dreams were kept beside your pillow. Try to remember when life was so tender that love was an ember about to billow. Try to remember, and if you remember, then follow.
Follow, 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 follow.
Follow, 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 follow.
Follow, 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 follow.
Deep in December, it's nice to remember, although you know the snow will follow. Deep in December, it's nice to remember without a hurt, the heart is hollow. Deep in December, it's nice to remember the fire of September that made us mellow. Deep in December, our hearts should remember and follow.
Follow.
Now, let me tell you a few things you may want to know before we begin the play. First of all, the characters, a boy, a girl, two fathers, and a wall. Anything else that's needed we can get from out of this box. It's hard to know which is most important or how it all began. The boy was born, the girl was born. They grew up quickly, went to school, and became shy. In their own ways and for different reasons. They read romances, studied cloud formations in the lazy afternoon, and instead of read textbooks, tried to memorize the moon. And when the girl was 16, she was younger than the boy. She began to notice something strange. Her ugly duckling features had undergone a change. In short, she was growing pretty. For the first time in her whole life, pretty. And the shock so stunned and thrilled her that she became almost immediately, incurably insane. Observe.
The moon turns red on my birthday, and it always will until somebody saves me and takes me back to my palace.
That is a typical remark. The other symptoms vary. She thinks that she is a princess, that her name must be in French or sometimes Eurasian, although she isn't quite sure what that is.
You see, no one can feel the way I feel and have a father named Amos Babcock Bellamy.
She has a glue paste necklace that she thinks is really real.
I found it in the attic with my mother's name inside. It is my favorite possession.
It is her fancy.
It's my pride. This morning, a bird woke me up. It was a lark, or a peacock, or something like that. Some strange sort of bird that I'd never heard. And I said hello, and it vanished. Flew away, the very minute I said hello. It was mysterious. So you know what I did? I went over to my mirror and put on my mother's necklace, and the minute the jewels touched my skin, my eyes turned mauve! No, honestly, mauve! And then blue, and then a sort of deep magenta when the sun hit them. I am 16 years old, and every day something happens to me. I don't know what to make of it. When I get up in the morning to get dressed, I can tell something is different. I like to touch my eyelids because they're never quite the same. I hug myself until my arms turn blue, and then I close my eyes and I cry until the tears come down and I can taste them. I love to taste my tears. I am special. I am special. Please, God, please don't let me be normal. I'd like to swim in a clear blue stream where the water is icy cold, then go to town in a golden gown and have my fortune told. Just once before I'm old, I'd like to be not evil but a little worldly wise, to be the kind of girl designed to be kissed upon the eyes. I'd like to dance till 2 o'clock, or sometimes dance till dawn, or if the band could stand it, just go on and on and on. Just once before the chance is gone. I'd like to waste a week or two and never do a chore, to wear my hair unfastened so it billows to the floor, to do the things I dreamed about but never done before. Perhaps I'm bad or wild or mad, with lots of grief in store, but I want much more than keeping house, much more, much more.
Good, and now for the boy. His story may be a wee bit briefer because it's pretty much the same.
There is this girl.
That is the essence.
There is this girl.
I warn you, it may be monotonous.
There is this girl. I'm nearly 20 years old. I've studied biology, I've had an education, been inside of a lab, dissected violets. I know the way things are. I'm grown up, stable, willing to conform. I'm beyond such foolish notions. Yet in spite of my knowledge, there's this girl. She makes me young again and foolish. And with her, I perform the impossible. I defy my biology and achieve ignorance.
Look. This is the wall their fathers built between their houses.
They built it ages ago, last month, when I came home from school. Poor fools, they built it to keep us apart. Maybe she's there now. Oh, I hope so. I'll see. I don't know what to call her. She's too vibrant for a name. What shall I call her? Juliet!
Yes, dear!
Helena! Cassandra, and Cleopatra, and Beatrice, and also Guinevere.
Oh, dear.
I think she's there. I love you. If I were in the desert deep in sand, and the sun was burning like a hot pomegranate, walking through the nightmare in the heat of a summer day, until my mind was parched. Then you or water. Clear, cool water. A refreshing glass of water.
What, dear?
Water! Love, you are love. Better far than a metaphor can ever, ever be. Love, you are love. My mystery of love. If the world was like an iceberg and everything was frozen and tears turned into icicles in the eye and snow came pouring and sleet and ice came stabbing like a knife, then you are heat, a fire alive with heat, a flame that thaws the iceberg with its heat.
Repeat.
You are heat.
Love,
you are love.
I am love,
better far than a metaphor can ever, ever be.
Love,
you are love.
I am love.
My mystery,
mystery of love.
You are Polaris, the untrustworthy star. You are,
I am.
You are,
I am.
You are September, a special mystery to me.
To me.
You are sunlight, mountains, valleys, the microscopic inside of a leaf. My joy,
yes,
my grief,
yes, I'm free.
My star.
Yes,
trembling.
My father loves to spy.
I know. My father locked my room. I had to climb out through a window.
Oh, God, be careful. Suppose you were to fall.
It was on the ground floor.
Oh.
Still, the window's very small. I could get stuck.
This is madness, isn't it?
Yes, absolutely mad.
And also very wicked?
Yes.
I'm glad.
My father would be furious if he knew.
Listen, I've had a vision.
Of disaster?
No. Of azaleas.
Azaleas?
I dreamed I was picking an azalea when all at once this man... Oh, he was very old. I'd say nearly 40. But attractive and very evil.
I hate him.
He had a retinue of scoundrels hiding behind the rhododendrons. And as I picked an azalea, he leapt out!
God, I hate him!
In my vision, how I struggled, like the abduction of the Sabine women, I cried, help!
And I was nearby.
Yes, you came rushing to the rescue and, single-handed, fight off all his men and win.
And then?
Celebration!
Fireworks!
Fiesta!
Laughter!
Our fathers give in.
And we live happily ever after.
There's no reason in the entire world why it can't happen exactly like that.
Ahem.
Someone's coming!
It's my father.
Kiss me!
Too much moisture. There are a great many things I could tell you about myself. I was once in the Navy. That's where I learned horticulture. Yes, I've been the world over. I've seen it all. Mountain cactus, the century plant, Japanese ivy, and exotic ports where bogwort were still in the open market. I am a man of experience. And there is one thing that I've learned. Too much moisture is worse than none at all. Prune a plant, avoid water, and go easy on manure. Moderation, that's the moral. That's my son's foot.
Hello, Father.
What are you doing up in that tree?
Writing verses.
Curses.
How's that?
I offer Father's curses to the type of education that makes our children fools. I sent this boy to school, to college, and I hope you know what that costs. Did he learn to dig a cesspool? No, but he's up there now, writing verses. Why do I always find you standing beside that wall?
I'm waiting for it to fall. Besides, I like it. I like its lovely texture and pretty little eyes.
Walls don't have eyes.
Then what do you call this flower?
Sweet God, he's clever!
Son, you're an ass. There you stand every day, writing verses, while who knows what our neighbor's up to on the other side of that wall. He's a villain! I'll not have it. I'll strip those branches where an enemy could climb. I'll line the wall with bottles. I'll jack it up with glass. What was that?
Some broken willow, wounded little bird.
Maybe, but walls have ears even if they don't have eyes. I'll just take a look. There is that stiffness again. The result of my Navy career. Here, son, you climb. You can see for me.
All right, Father.
What do you see?
I love you.
I love you too.
What are you mumbling about? Get down from there if there isn't anything to be seen. Down, I say!
I obey.
Son, you're an idiot. So I decided that you need to be married. So I went shopping around and I picked you out a wife. There's that sound again.
Anguished little bird.
Weeping willow? It may be. But son, back to business. I picked you out a girl. A pearl.
And if I prefer a diamond?
How dare you prefer a diamond when I just offered you a pearl?
Listen carefully to what I have to say. Listen, wall and flower and wall and willow and wounded bird and father, you may as well listen too. I will not wed by his wisdom. I will not walk neatly into a church and contract out to prolongate my race.
Son, you need pruning. Come inside and write simplicity 200 times without stopping. Perhaps that will improve your style.
That's right. Drink away. Open your thirsty little mouths. I'm her father. And believe me, it isn't easy. Perhaps that's why I love vegetables. So dependable. I mean, you plant a radish, you know what you're about. You don't get a turnip or a cabbage. No. Plant a turnip, you get a turnip. Plant a cabbage, get a cabbage. But while with children, I thought I had planted a turnip, or at worst, perhaps an avocado. Something remotely useful. I'm a merchant. I sell buttons. What need do I have for a rose? Well, there she is. Missy, you must go inside.
I told you, I'm a princess.
You're a button maker's daughter. Now go inside and do as you're told. Our enemy is beyond that wall. He's up to something, I can feel it. Him and his no good son! Look out! You stepped in my peppers! That settles it. I'll put a fence here by this wall. A high fence, barbed with stickers, and an arsenal of wire.
A fence is expensive, Papa.
Expensive? Well, I'll do it myself. Go inside, do as I tell you. Is she gone? Yep, she's gone.
Olalia,
hee-hoo! Olalia,
hee-hoo! Huckleby!
Bellamy!
Neighbor!
Friend!
How's the gout?
I barely notice. In your asthma.
A trifle. I endure it.
Well, it's nearly settled.
What is?
The marriage! They're nearly ready! I hid in the bushes to listen. Oh, it's something. They're out of their minds with love.
Oh, hooray!
My son, he is fantastic.
My daughter is fantastic, too. They're both of them mad.
They are geese.
It was a clever plan we had to build this wall.
Yes, and to pretend to feud.
Just think if they knew that we wanted them wed.
A prearranged marriage?
They'd rather be dead.
Children!
Lovers!
Fantastics!
Geese!
How clever we are!
How crafty to know!
To manipulate children!
You merely say
no!
Oh, dogs got to bark, a mule's got to bray, soldiers must fight, and preachers must pray, and children, I guess, must get their own way the minute that you say no! Why did the kids pour jam on the cats? A raspberry jam all over the cats? Why should the kids do something like that when all that we said was no?
My son was once afraid to swim. The water made him wince until I said he mustn't swim. Since swimming ever since.
Been swimming ever since. Oh, dogs got to bark, mules got to pray, soldiers must fight, and preachers must pray, and children, I guess, must get their own way the minute that you say no.
Why did the kids put beans in their ears? No one can hear with beans in their ears.
Well, after a while, the reason appears. They did it 'cause we said no.
Your daughter brings a young man and says, do you like him, Pa? Just tell her he's a fool, and then you've got a son-in-law.
You've got a son-in-law. Oh, sure as a June comes right after May, sure as the night comes right after day, you can be sure the devil's to pay the minute that you say no. Make sure you never say no.
But there's just one problem left.
How to end the feud.
Exactly. You guessed it. We mustn't let them know.
Oh no, if they knew, we're finished.
We're through.
I think I found the answer. It's delicious. Very theatrical. An abduction.
Well, who's abducted?
Your daughter.
And who abducts her?
A professional abductor, and I've hired the very man.
Gentlemen! Good evening.
What the devil?
Who are you?
I was sent for. A family in distress.
Oh, yes, of course. The famous El Gallo?
El Gallo.
Oh, see.
See!
See? This is what I was about to tell you. This man is a magician. He can help us. You see, we have ourselves a problem.
Ah, yes. A love problem.
A love problem, and you've called me to fix it. Interesting. Very interesting.
Wait a minute!
We're not talking about us! We're talking about our children!
Who happens to be a boy and a girl!
Less challenging, but I'll see what I can do. You say you have a daughter.
Yes.
I see a girl.
Is her name Louisa?
Is that your daughter's name?
Yes.
That's her! She's standing next to a young man who must be... Quick, before the image fades!
Matt,
exactly!
Oh my god!
You're amazing!
They seem... happy enough.
What about the feud?
The feud, yes, of course, the feud.
That's what I contacted you about. See, this is what I was about to tell you. We hire this man to assist us. He starts to kidnap your daughter. My son runs in to save her, then a battle.
I allow the boy to defeat me?
Yes, my son becomes a hero and the feud is over for all time.
Oh, how much for such a drama?
That, senor, depends.
On what?
What else? The extent of the rapture.
Nope.
The raid, the capture. Call it what you will.
I heard her speak of Sabine women.
Well, it doesn't sound right to me.
Oh, it is, though. As a matter of fact, I assure you, it's quite standard. The lovers meet in secret, and so forth. A group of villains interrupts them, and so forth. The boy fights off pirates, bandits, brigands. Parents relent. A happy ending. And so forth. All of it. Quite standard.
Yes, but what about the cost? And so forth.
Cost goes by type. For you, I think I might recommend a first class.
You mean we get a choice?
Yes, of course. With regular union rates. Depends on what you pay. To pay, so come on and pay. The obvious open schoolboy chase, little mandolins and a fast embrace, a childish prank. It's little in request, a first class raid. That is what I would suggest. Just try to see it, and you will soon agree, senors. Why invite regret? When you can order an abduction, you will never forget. An abduction that's emphatic, an abduction that's polite. An abduction done with musketeers, a truly charming sight. An abduction done on horseback, they all say it's new and gay. So you see, the masquerade depends on what you pay. It depends on what you pay.
The kids will love it. It depends on what you pay. So why be stingy? It depends on what
the
you...
The spectacular raid, with costumes ordered from the... requires rehearsal. Takes a dozen men at least.
12 men?
That's a dozen.
A couple of singers and a string quartet. A major production requires a set.
Sounds very expensive.
Just try to see it. And you will soon see, senors. Why invite regret? When you can order an abduction, you will never forget. An abduction that's emphatic, an abduction that's polite. An abduction done with musketeers, a truly charming sight. An abduction done on horseback, they all say it's new and gay. So you see, the masquerade depends on what you pay. So you see, the masquerade depends on what you pay. It depends on what you pay.
So why be stingy? It depends on what you pay.
The kids will love it.
It depends on what you
pay. The comic snatch. Perhaps just a trifle too unique. The pastoral. Done while canoeing on a moonlit creek.
Now that's kind of pretty.
The gothic robe. I play Valkyrie on a bass bassoon. The drunken brawl. I fight the boy inside a cheap saloon.
Nothing cheap.
Perhaps you'd like our special raid ballet. I make an entrance doing grand jeté. Ballet's expensive, but it's in demand. A military siege is done with drummers and a band. You understand?
I understand.
It's very grand.
It's very grand.
It's done with drums and a great big brass band.
Yeah! It's so Spanish, that's why I like it.
I like it too.
Just try to see it.
I see.
Invite regret. When you can order an abduction, you will never forget.
An abduction that's dramatic, an abduction that's polite, an abduction
depends on what you pay. So you see, the masquerade depends on what you pay. So you see, the masquerade depends on what you pay. So you see, the masquerade depends on what you pay. 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 Depends a lot on what you.
I say they're only young once. Let's order them a first class.
One abduction, first class.
With trimmings?
With trimmings. Now, is it to be a big affair or intimate?
We thought just the children.
I meant afterwards, at the party.
No, just the immediate family.
No guests, perhaps a gathering on the lawn.
Too expensive. Just the immediate family will be enough.
As you wish. That means the orchestra can go home. Although, big affairs are nice.
Perhaps some other time.
As you wish. You better go home and rehearse your parts.
An abduction that's dramatic, an abduction that's polite, an abduction done with musketeers, a truly charming sight.
A major production to do. Time is rushing. I need actors, extra actors, to stage my elaborate abduction, but I'm not worried. Something will turn up. I can sense it in the air. There. You hear? What did I tell you?
Sir, the players have arrived.
Senor, the players are most welcome.
Don't look at us as we are, sir. Please remove 10 pounds of dust from these aged, wrinkled cheeks. See makeup, caked in glowing powder pink. Imagine a beard full-blown and blowing like the whiskers on a bear.
Rah!
And hair. Imagine hair. In a box they've got all colors, so I beg you, imagine hair. And not these clothes. Oh, no, 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 no! Dear God, not rags like any beggar has. But see me in a robe. Mortimer, fetch the robe. There! Imagine. It's torn. I know. Forget it. Try and see it under the light. That's it. That's the whole trick. Try and see it under the light. I recite. Say a cue. You'll see. I'll know it. Go on. Say one. Try me.
Friends, Romans, countrymen.
It's what?
Friends, Romans, countrymen.
No, no, don't tell me I can get it. Let's see. Friends. Romans.
Countrymen.
I can't see a blind word you're saying.
Countrymen.
Why, yes, of course, that's easy. Why don't you try something hard? Watch this. Friends. Romans, countrymen. Screw your courage to the sticking place, and be not sick and pale with grief. And thou, her handmaiden, should be far more fair than she is. How's that?
Amazing!
Try and see it under the light, I assure you, it's dazzling. I'm Henry Arbutson. Perhaps you recall my Hamlet.
Of course.
You remember! Would you like to see the clippings?
Perhaps later.
As you wish. I preserve them, who knows?
I may write a book someday. This is Mortimer. He does death scenes. He's been with me for 40 years. Would you like to see one? He's an expert. Go ahead, Mortimer. Die for the man. I tell you. Now, down to business. You, sir, the players.
For a love scene, have you done romantic drama, Henry?
That, sir, is my specialty. Have you never seen my Romeo?
I'm afraid not.
You haven't seen my Romeo?
I don't think I was born yet.
What about my Leo?
Sorry.
Richard the Third? Richard the Second? My bottom. Surely you've seen my bottom. My bottom was famous. If you'd seen my bottom, you'd never forget it. I have the clippings.
Henry, here's the path.
Uh-huh.
We'll have the players play something like the abduction of the maiden before this lover.
And if he but blink,
we'll stand our ground and fight until the lot of us is downed.
Nobly done.
This way, Henry.
Psst. Henry.
What?
Where do you want me?
Oh, off left, Mortimer, off left. Peasants are always off left.
Henry!
What?
What's me cue?
I'll tell you when it's time. Oh, and Mortimer. Dress the stage, dress the stage. Don't cluster up when you die.
Right, right.
Well, that about does it. I'd imagine we'd better hide.
Oh, I nearly forgot. I promised them moonlight.
Amazing.
Beautiful, there. Lover's moon. You go ahead, Henry. I'll see you later. You wonder how these things begin. Well, this begins with a glen. It begins with a season which, for want of a better word, we might as well call September. It begins in a forest where the woodchucks woo and leaves wax green. And vines entwine like lovers. Try to see it. Not with your eyes, for they are wise, but see it with your ears. The cool green breathing of the leaves. And hear it with the inside of your hand. The soundless sound of shadows flicking light. Celebrate sensation. Recall that secret place. You've been there. You remember that special place for once, just once in your crowded sunlit lifetime, you hid away in shadows from the tyranny of time. That spot beside the clover where someone's hand held your hand, and love was sweeter than the berries, or the honey, or the stinging taste of mint. It is September, before rainfall, perfect time to be in love.
I know, so is mine.
You've never been here at night?
No.
Different from the day.
Are you frightened?
Yes. No. It's cold. There's going to be a storm.
Would you like my jacket?
No. Thank you. Matt?
Yes?
My hand is trembling.
Don't be afraid.
All right, I promise.
They're there. It's all right.
Matt, take care of me. I don't want to be awkward and afraid. I love you, Matt. I want there to be a happy ending.
I promise that there will be. Look.
What?
My hand's trembling too.
Hear how the wind begins to whisper. See how the leaves go streaming by. Smell how the velvet rain is falling out where the fields are warm and dry. Now is the time to run inside and stay. Now is the time to find a hideaway where we can stay.
Soon it's gonna rain, I can see it. Soon it's gonna rain, I can tell. Soon it's gonna rain, what are we gonna do? Soon it's gonna rain, I can feel it. Soon it's gonna rain, I can tell. Soon it's gonna rain, what'll we do? We'll find four limbs of a tree we'll build, four walls and a floor we'll bind it over with leaves and duck inside to stay. Then we'll let it rain, we'll not feel it. Then we'll let it rain, rain pell mell, and we'll not complain if it never stops at all. We'll live and love within our own four walls. We'll find four limbs of a tree.
We'll build four walls and a floor.
We'll bind it over with leaves and run inside to stay.
Accelerando con molto prosciutto. Get the swords. Musketeers ready. Musketeers abduct.
Ah!
Oh no, I've left
them. Come on there.
Who are they? What? What was that? Oh my god! Who are you?
Hey, big guy. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
A touch, a touch. I do confess it.
What? Ah! Oh my god.
Dad? Wait.
Be careful.
You fight like my mother.
Thanks.
the breach, dear friends.
There's more of them?
How are we losing? There's three of us.
Hold your way.
I'm nearly 20 years old.
You're doing great.
It's my cardio for the day.
Ah! Is anyone a doctor?
Oh, for God of England, Harriet St. Jock. Ow! I watched half a Bruce Willis movie earlier.
Well, I watched Boys to Men.
Oh, I should have really bought the short-term health insurance.
Get a bit sore versus dying like that. It's not the easiest thing in the business, but I like it. I've been dying for over 40 years, ever since I was a boy. Oh, you should have seen me in those days. I would die off a 20-foot cliff. Backwards, people used to cry out, "Die again, Mortimer, die again." But, of course, I never did.
Well, Henry, are you off now?
Yes, somewhere. There's not much left for the old company anymore. Just Mortimer and me. But we do all right. I recite Shakespeare. And Mortimer dies. There's usually an audience somewhere.
Henry.
Oh, I nearly forgot. Here's your moon.
Thank you. Good night, sweet prince.
And flights of angels sing the... That's my light.
Thank you.
And flight of angels sing thee to thy rest. Remember, Mortimer, they're no small part, only small actors. Remember me in life.
Very beautiful, eh? Worthy of a Watteau, a group of living statues, what do they call it? A tableau? I wonder if they can hold it. They'll try to, I suppose, and yet it can't be easy to hold such a pretty pose. We'll see. We'll leave them for a little. Then we'll see. Act one is over. The intermission is now. Please, we would really appreciate it if you would donate as you grab one of the wonderful Carlsbad Danish bakery treats. And we'll see you in the second act. Thank you.
Let's go. Okay, I get it. I get it. I get it.
Come on.
All right, all right.
Let's go. Watch your step. Stop being on my careful.
Hi, Mom.
Let's go. All right.
I forgot to pee.
How do you forget to pee?
You had so much time. All right.
Their moon was cardboard. Fragile, it was... Very apt to fray in what was last night, scenic may seem, cynic by today. The play is not done, oh no, not quite, for life never ends in the moonlit night, and despite what pretty poets say, the night is only half the day. So we would like to truly finish what was foolishly begun, because the
play has never ended and the story is never done until we've, all of us, been burned a bit and burnished by the sun.
It's hot!
What?
Hot!
Oh.
And now we can meet in the sunlight.
And now there's no more wall.
Aren't we happy?
Yeah, aren't we?
He looks different in the sunlight.
I'm not ready to get married yet.
I thought he was taller somehow.
When you get right down to it, she's only the girl next door.
Neighbor?
Friends.
In-law.
Oh.
Well, this is what we've always wanted. Our gardens are one.
We're merged.
Related.
Amalga.
Made it?
Well.
What shall we do today?
Whatever you say.
And tomorrow?
The same. I wonder where that road goes.
I'd like to take my clothes off and go swimming in a stream.
Water. Water. Water.
What did you say?
I said, water, water, water.
Clip, clip, clip.
What?
You're clipping my kumquats.
Right.
This plum is too ripe.
Sorry. Please don't watch me while I'm eating.
Sorry.
You're about to drown that magnolia.
Sorry. You're standing in my kumquat.
Sorry.
Take away the painted sunset, take away the blue lagoon. What at night seems oh so scenic, maybe cynic much too soon.
Take away the sense of drama, take away the puppet play. What a night seems oh so scenic, maybe cynic by today.
Take away the secret meetings, take away the chance to fight. What at night seems oh so scenic, maybe cynic in the light.
So take it away and paint it upright. So take it away and decorate it. So take it away, that sun is too bright.
I see that it really is a pity.
It used to be so pretty.
Take away the golden moonbeam.
Take away the painted sunset. Take away the blue lagoon. What a night, so, so scenic. Maybe
away. Such to scenic. What at night seems oh so scenic, maybe cynic in the light.
By today, much too soon, by and by.
This plum is too ripe.
Sorry!
I miss the moon.
So do I.
I was a fool to tear down that wall.
So was I. I hate people tromping in my garden.
Gentlemen, my bill.
What is this?
An itemized bill for your pretty little abduction.
I don't believe it.
Read on, Macduff.
Item. A silver piece for actors to portray bloodthirsty bandits, fake blood included? Item. A piece in gold to the famous El Gallo.
El Gallo.
Gallo. For allowing himself to seem wounded by a beardless callow boy? Item. One moon. I see you spare no pains.
You mean it wasn't real? The bandits? The moonlight?
Everything.
But it isn't fair. We didn't need your moonlight. We're in love. We could have made our own moons.
My child. You see, you have spoiled everything.
I told you it wouldn't work.
You told you? Why, you liar. Get out of my kumquat.
Damn your kumquat.
That does it. You're a murderer.
And you're at fault.
Drown, drown.
On guard.
Pardon me.
Damn.
It's my bandit.
Wait. You are El Gallo?
Sometimes.
About this bill, I think you earned it rather easily.
You made it rather easy to earn.
Well, that's true, but now I'll make it harder. Where's my sword? Someone get me a sword.
Nice boy.
En garde.
Up a bit with the wrist, aim at the entrails, that foot back more. Very good, encore. Thrust one, thrust two, bend the knee, thrust three, but then be sure to parry like this. See? Another lesson?
Matt. You. You!
Villain? Don't do that, you'll hurt your hand.
Matt, wait!
What?
I just want to tell you I think you were right.
Right?
Not to pick up the sword, not to fight him. I mean, you might have gotten hurt. I mean, maybe you're not ready to be a hero. I mean, not yet.
Well, maybe I can be the villain instead. He seems to have all the good scenes, at least with you.
Don't do that, you'll hurt your hand.
What a line!
You know what I think? I think you'd better grow up.
Grow up. Grow up. And this is from a girl who is 16.
Girls mature faster.
No, this can't be happening. If I'm not mad, if I'm not gloriously insane, then I'm just me. And if I'm just me, then I can see.
What?
Everything. All the flaws, you're childish.
Childlike.
Silly.
Soulful.
And your freckles.
That is a lie.
I can see under those pounds of powder. Look, freckles.
You're a poser. I've heard you talking in the garden, walking around, reciting romantic poems about yourself. The great swordsman.
You're adolescent. Beyond that road lies adventure.
I'm going to take my clothes off and go swimming in a stream.
You'll never hear me again, my dear. I've decided to be bad.
I'll stay up all night and sing songs to the moon.
I'll drink and gamble. I'll grow a mustache. I'll find my madness somewhere out there.
I'll find mine too. I'll have an affair.
Goodbye forever.
See if I care.
This tear may be enough, this tiny tear. The boy will go, the girl will stay. Thus runs the world away. See, he sees it, and the world seems very grand.
Beyond that road lies a shining world.
On that road lies despair.
Beyond that road lies a world that's gleaming.
People who are scheming.
Beauty.
Hunger.
Glory.
Sorrow.
Never a pain nor care.
He's alive. To find a couple of surprises there.
There's a song he must sing, it's a well-known song, but the tune is bitter and it doesn't take long to learn.
I can learn.
That pretty little world that beams so bright, that pretty little world that seems delightful can burn.
Let me learn. Somewhere, invite me to come there and learn. And I'm ready, I can hear it. Sirens singing. Inside my ear, I hear them all singing. Come learn. All the visions that I see may be waiting just for me to say, take me there and make me see it, make me feel it. I know it's so, I know that it really may be.
Shining somewhere. Those lights not only glitter, but once there, they burn.
I can see it. I can hear it.
Can hear it.
Siren
singing. Don't listen close, or maybe you'll never.
I can hear it.
Who knows, maybe all the visions I can see may be waiting just for me to say.
I can see it shining somewhere. Let me see it. Take me there and make me a part of it. Make me see those shining sights inside of me.
So I know that it really
may be just what I've always waited for. This is what my life's created for. Let me learn.
Teach him very quickly the secret he needs to know, a certain parable about romance, and so we let him go. We commit him to the tender mercies of that most stringent teacher, time, but just so there's no slip-up, we'll add a bit of spice.
Hold on there a minute, matey.
And what? Where may you be going, my fiery-eyed young friend? Don't bother to answer. I can see it in your eyes.
I see it too in them beady little eyes.
You go for the goose, the golden goose that lays the platinum-plated egg. Right!
Right.
Right. I am Lodovico. Like yourself, a young rooster looking for the pleasant pinch of adventure.
Young rooster?
Yes, young cock-a-doodle-doo. And to your left, observe this seamy individual. He is my companion who goes by the name of Socrates.
I'm Roman.
Roman off, he means. A blue blood. He's descended from the Tzars.
The Tzars?
Yes, the Tzars. He is, in fact, the noblest Roman off them all. But enough chit-chats.
Enough, enough.
You long for adventure?
We'll take you, won't we, Sucky?
We'll take him, all right.
We'll take you to all the places you've ever dreamed of. Venice, Egypt. Egypt. I'm dying, Egypt. That's a line from something. I just can't remember what.
I thought I would.
Seek your fortune, of course. Exactly why we're here. Right, Sucky?
Right, Lodi. We're gonna give you the word.
The fireworks, he means.
It was my intention.
Forget intentions. They've paved the road to hell. We'll see to your education.
We know all the ropes.
And all the ropes to skip as well.
Heathen idols.
Whirling girlies.
Tipsy gypsies.
Fantastic beauty just waiting to be unzipped.
But I...
Don't bother to thank us.
Now, grant me in your minds a month. October is over, the sky grows gray. A month goes by, it's a little bit colder. A month goes by, we're 1 month older.
Now that is fine. There's nothing better than a good thick wall. Keep on working, my friend. Keep on working.
Still progressing. Good. We want to get it finished before snowfall.
It's getting colder. You know, I'll just take a look at the wall. Great job. Keep on working. Oh, Lord, this weather makes a man feel old.
Not a word. He's been gone for a month, and I haven't had a single word. How's it going? Oh, I forgot. You're not supposed to talk.
Louisa! Now, dear, listen. It's silly to be standing in the garden. You'll catch asthma. You'll catch pneumonia. Louisa! Well, anyways, I brought you a little shawl. I don't suppose you'd care to see my garden.
She won't answer.
I don't recall addressing that remark to you, sir.
She's not supposed to speak.
Oh. Oh, well. By the way.
Yes?
No, nothing. What's so funny?
I was just thinking about how we used to meet.
Climbing over the wall.
Secret meetings.
Just to get a chance at playing a little game of cards.
Good times.
How's your son?
Not a word.
He'll come back when he runs out of your money.
Thank you. And your daughter?
Like a statue. There's nothing but sit there and dream all day.
Pity. How's your garden?
Growing.
Mine too.
You know, they're so dependable. Gardens go on growing.
Yes, indeed they do.
I tell you, I love vegetables.
Oh, it's true. I love them too.
Plant a radish, get a radish, never any doubt. That's why I love vegetables, you know what you're about.
Plant a turnip, get a turnip, maybe you'll get two. That's why I love vegetables, you know that they'll come through.
They're dependable,
they're befriendable.
They're the best pal a parent's ever known. While with children,
it's bewildering.
You don't know until the seed is nearly grown. Just what you've sown, so plant a carrot.
Get a carrot,
not a Brussels sprout.
That's why I love vegetables, you know what you're about.
Life is merry,
if it's very vegetarian.
A man who plants a garden is a very happy man.
Oh-ho! Go on, old chap.
Alrighty.
Got the moves in me still.
Land a beanstalk, get a beanstalk just the same as Jack. Then, if you don't like it, you can always take it back.
But if your issue doesn't kiss you, then I wish you luck. For once you planted children, you're absolutely stuck.
Every turnip green, every kidney bean, every plant grows according to the plot.
While the progeny,
it's such progeny.
For as soon as you think you know what kind you've got,
it's what they're not. So, plant a cabbage, get a cabbage, not a sauerkraut.
That's why I love vegetables, you know what you're about.
Life is merry if it's very vegetarian. A man who plants a garden is a very happy man.
A vegetarian.
Very merry vegetarian. Say, what about that little game of cards? Binnacle?
I prefer poker.
All right, but let's hurry.
You still owe me from last time.
That's true, that's true.
Keep on working.
She's a good worker.
I'd like to swim in a clear blue stream with a water as icy cold, then go to town in a golden gown and have my fortune told.
Just once before you're old.
It's my bandit.
Your bandit, yes.
What are you doing up in that tree?
Growing ripe.
Don't grow too ripe or you'll fall.
Very wise.
What do you see from up there?
Everything.
Really?
Nearly.
Do you see Matt?
Do you care?
No, I just wondered. Can I climb up there beside you?
You can if you can.
There. I don't see everything.
It takes a little while.
All I see is my own house. And Matt's. And the wall.
And that's all?
All. Is it fun to be a bandit?
It has its moments.
I think it must be fun. Tell me, do you ride on a great white horse?
I used to.
But no longer?
I developed a saddle rash. Very painful.
How unglamorous. I never heard of a hero who had a saddle rash.
Oh, it happens. Occupational hazard.
Tell me, what's your favorite plunder?
Plunder? I think that's pirates.
Well then, booty.
You've been reading too many books.
Well, you must steal something.
Oh yes, I steal fancies. I steal whatever is treasured most.
That's more like it. Precious rubies.
Precious rhinestones.
Rhinestones?
Can be precious, depends on the point of view.
Doesn't sound very sound. Economically, I mean.
Pretty child.
Do you think so? Do I attract you?
Somewhat.
Oh, but that's splendid! See this ribbon? That's where you gave me a bruise.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Tell me, have you seen the world?
A bit, yes.
Is it like in the books?
Depends on what books you read.
The adventures, the romances! Cast off thy name, a rose by any other name. Do you know that?
Sounds familiar.
Put up thy sword, the dew will rust it! That's Othello. He was older than Desdemona, but she loved him because he had seen the world. Of course, he killed her.
Of course.
It is a far greater thing that I do now than I have ever done before. Isn't that beautiful?
Yeah.
That man was beheaded.
Doesn't surprise me.
Take me there.
Where?
To the parties, to the world!
But I'm a bandit. There's a price upon my head.
Oh, I was hoping there would be.
You and I. Us together.
Yes. Dancing forever and forever.
Round and round till the break of day, candles glow, fiddles play. Why not be wild if we feel that way? Reckless and terribly gay. Round and round neath the magic spell, velvet gown, pink lapel. Life is a colorful carousel, reckless and terribly gay.
I'm ready anytime if you take me. Try to be ready to go.
I seem to see Venice, we're on a lagoon. A gondola's crooning a gondola tune. The air makes your hair blow blue in the moon.
I could swoon!
You're so blue in the moon.
Oh, look! It's carnival in Venice! How exciting! That boy, he looks familiar.
Well, you know, those country peasants all look the same.
His friends, they're getting him drunk. Oh no, they're stealing his money.
Pay no attention.
But the fireworks, he's in trouble, he's caught fire.
Just put up a mask, then it's pretty.
Oh, isn't he beautiful? He's all sort of orange, red orange. That's one of my favorite colors.
Help!
You look lovely.
We'll just dance. We'll kick up our heels to music and dance. Until our head reels with music, just like a lovely real romance. So we'll do his daily dance. All we'll do is just dance. All we'll do is just dance.
Oh, couldn't we just sit this one out?
Ridiculous. The evening's just beginning. Round and round till the break of day. Candles glow, fiddles play. Why not be wild if we feel that way? Reckless and terribly gay.
I'm ready anytime if you take me. I'm ready to go. So show the way to me. I will try to be ready to go.
I seem to see Athens, it's terribly chic. Atop the Acropolis, it's terribly Greek. I hear that the yacht club is simply unique.
Oh, how chic!
To be Greek cheek to cheek.
There's that boy again. And it looks like he's in prison.
Doesn't surprise me.
What are they doing? They're tying him up. Oh no, they're beginning to whip him!
Just put up the mask.
But he's wounded!
The mask!
Oh, I see. It's for his own good. You have to teach them some respect for the law. Don't stop! It's charming! Don't stop!
Help!
Oh, that's it! Rive some more!
We'll just dance. We'll kick up our heels to music and dance. Until our head reels with music just like a lovely real romance. All we'll do is daily dance. All we'll do is just dance. We'll do is just dance. You can't be. Not when there's music to be danced to. Play, gypsies!
Round and round neath a magic spell, velvet gown, pink lapel. Life is a colorful carousel, reckless and terribly
grown. I'm ready anytime, so take me, I'm ready to go. So show the way to me, so try to be ready to grow.
We'll be in Bombaza, maybe Bombay. I hear with the rate of exchange you can pay the natives to slave for just pennies a day.
We can play?
Yes, while they're slaving away.
I think I'm going to love India. Such a big population, and I adore crowds. Oh, look! There's that boy again. How wild he looks.
Probably on drugs.
They're leading him through the village. And now they're putting him down on some nails. If he fails, he'll be cut to bits by those nails.
Help!
Somebody help him!
Put up the mask.
But he's bleeding horribly!
The mask!
Go on, sit down harder. They don't feel pain the same as we do. I don't believe he's a real faker. They never complain. He's a fake faker.
Help!
Fake!
Will just
dance.
We'll kick up our heels to music and
dance
until it reels to music just like a lovely wheel. And that's what we'll do is daily. I can see the waves. All we'll do is just dance. All we'll do is just dance. All we'll do is just round and round neath the magic snow. All we'll do is just. 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 All we'll do is just
help.
Dance. Well, you must hurry and pack so that we may run away.
I'm afraid.
Of what?
I don't know of what. Something out there. Something in the dark.
Maybe you'd better stay home.
No, I have to go. All my life I've waited for something wonderful to happen, and this is my chance. Perhaps I'm bad or wild or mad. I have to go.
Very well. Go pack your things.
Kiss me first.
What is it?
At last, I have been kissed upon the eyes. No matter what happens, I will never, ever forget that kiss. I'll go now.
One word, Louisa. Listen, I must tell you this. I promised to remember, too, that one particular kiss. And now hurry! We have a lifetime for kisses.
True. You'll be here?
Right here, I promise. Oh, wait. Give me a trinket, a pledge that you will come back. That necklace.
Was my mother's.
Good. It will serve as your pledge.
All right. I leave this to you because it is my favorite possession. Guard it. I won't be long. Is it really like that? The world is like you say?
Of course. Beyond that road lies a shining world.
Beyond that road lies.
Beyond that road lies a world that's gleaming.
People who are scheming.
Beauty.
Hunger.
Glory.
Sorrow.
Never a pain or care.
She's liable to find a couple of surprises there.
I'm ready. I won't be long. You will be here.
I promise.
Wait.
Well, the prodigal son comes home.
Where did you get that necklace?
What? Oh, this? It's just a souvenir.
It's Louisa's, isn't it? You stole it!
Please. She gave it to me. Not that it's any business of yours.
Give it back!
There's a curious paradox that no one can explain. Who understands the secret of the reaping of the grain? Who understands why spring is born out of winter's laboring pain? Or why we all must die a bit before
before we grow again. I do not know the answer, I merely know it's true. I hurt them for that reason. And myself, a bit too.
Elgayo! Elgayo?
It isn't worth tears, believe me. Louisa, please, don't cry.
You look awful.
I know.
What's that swelling?
That's my eye.
And those scratches, what in the world happened to you?
The world happened to me.
Did you drink and gamble?
The first day, yeah, but the drink was drugged and the wheel kept hitting sixes until I played a six.
Did you serenade, senoras?
I can't remember. I was drugged or hypnotized or something. There was a funny light and mirrors.
I know.
And music, some sort of strange music. And people turning, spinning.
Wearing masks.
I remember crying out.
But no one came to help you. I'm so sorry, Matt.
No, it's all right. I deserve it. I've been foolish.
I have too. Believe me, more than you.
When the moon was young, when the month was May, when the stage was hung for my holiday, I saw shining lights, but I never knew they were you, they were you, they were.
Here, take my coat.
No, both. There's room enough for both.
Love, you are love.
You are love
better far than a metaphor can ever, ever be. Love,
you are love.
My miss.
Would you look at that?
They've come back.
It's a miracle. Let's tear down this wall.
Leave the waltz, not about the wall.
Deep in December, it's nice to remember, although you know the snow will follow. Deep in December, it's nice to remember. without a hurt. The heart is hollow. Deep in December, it's nice to remember the fire of September that made us mellow. Deep in December, it's nice to remember and follow.
Mr. Schwartz, can you turn my mic up? All right, thank you everybody so much for coming. My mom does not know about this, so that probably explains the anxious look on her face. But, you know, I just wanted to take a little bit of a moment to express my gratitude, I'm sure everybody else's gratitude, to my wonderful mother, Mrs. Gardner. So the two of us have been doing shows together since I was 8 years old. I'm now 19, and so this means it's, you know, unfortunately it's going to be my last show because of college and, you know, whatever other stuff goes on when you become adult. you know, I just wanted to say that, you know, Mom, it's been wonderful to get to know all these wonderful friends. All of us, I've been with Sydney and Nathan since we were like in third grade. I've been with Luca since we were in like fourth grade, and I've gotten to know some new faces as well. And you know, it's been all these wonderful friends and all the memories we've made, but Mom, most importantly, it's been the moments I've been able to spend with you. I really would not trade it for the world. And I'm sure every single one of us would say the same thing if we were able to hold up all these wonderful people for a couple moments. But I just wanted to express that, and thank you so much, Mom. I really appreciate it.